took this definition of leadership, starting with where we just talked about of mobilizing people around a common goal, but we expanded it a little bit, that what leadership is achieving significant positive impact, and I underline those words, that it's differentiated from management. Management gets things done, gets projects done, achieves goals, but leadership creates significant impact at a broader level. One of the leaders we talked to, Dom Barton, who was the managing director of McKinsey at the time we talked to him, was, you know, obviously runs a large organization himself, but also is in contact with almost all the CEOs around the world. He said that managers make sure that the trains run on the tracks, and trains run on time, but leaders move the tracks. Leaders figure out where the tracks ought to be going. And that's a very different kind of a role. What we found is that leadership emerges out of management. It's very difficult to be a good leader if you've never had any experience at actually getting stuff done and working with the team and getting them focused on a goal and achieving that. So that's almost like a threshold skill for leadership, is to be able to do that. Secondly, what we found is that leadership has to be learned through practice. And as we'll talk about in a moment, we talk about six fundamental practices. We use the word practices rather than skills or attributes. Use the word practices because it's about what leaders do. And practice means you have to keep practicing them. So these practices are practiced over the course of a career. Nobody starts out as the perfect leader. And actually, I'll tell you the dirty little secret, nobody ends up as the perfect leader. Everybody is working on becoming a better leader over time. And to do that, you have to keep practicing. And that's the third part of it, of our insights, is that there are six fundamental practices, which is about what leaders actually do, not who they are. Some of you may know there's lots of research done around World War II. It was the beginning of the real research, social scientific research about leadership. Around the time of World War II and then for the 10 or 15 years after that, about how do you find good leaders? Because during World War II, the Allies were concerned about where do we find good leaders to run the army, sergeants or colonels or how do we pick them to be good leaders? So they did a lot of research about what it meant to be a good leader. And they said, are good leaders, they did tests between left-handed people and right-handed people, taller people and shorter people, people with outgoing personalities and people who were shy and introverted. And did all kinds of studies, and some of them kind of silly. For example, one study was, can you tell a person who's going to be a good leader by whether they put salt on their food before they taste it or after they taste it? I don't know what that would actually mean, but that was one of the tests. So they go through all those tests, and what they found over the course of 10, 15, 20 years of research is that you can't predict who's going to be a good leader. It has very little to do with physical attributes or with personality. Leadership is much more about what people do. So our focus is on what do people do? What are the six essential practices that leaders carry out? So the six practices, kind of very simply, are creating a unifying vision, then having a strategy that turns that vision into reality, having the right people to be able to carry out that strategy, driving and focusing on results, which we'll talk about what that means, innovating over time so that you're not getting stale and stuck, and then finally, talk about leading yourself so that the leader continues to grow and develop and over time. So those are the six essential practices that leaders work on over time. And these are not, you know, when you write a book, you have to write a chapter one and two and three. And unfortunately, there's no way to write a circle book. But the idea is that these are not necessarily sequential. It's not like you have to start with one and then you get to six eventually. You have to think about all of them as a more integrated part of, as a leader, you have to think about all of them at one time or another. There are some that, as a leader, say, you know, I do that really well, but there are others I don't do well, and I'm going to work on those. It also depends on your organization. There may be times in the organization, in terms of the evolution of the organization, or the market, or the competition, where it's really important to work on one of those or two of those. and other times where it may be more important to focus on others. But a leader needs to keep sort of all of them in mind to be able to be effective as a leader. And the leaders that do a few of them well and a few of them terribly usually don't succeed.